Hello, good to see you all again here. This is Macy. Today we're going to talk about one of the highly requested topic, which is Admob for Unity. Google has improved this plugin a lot to make sure our life is a bit easier to implement ads onto our Unity games. However, it is still not that straightforward. Today's video, we are going to talk about Admob for Unity Android. Before we get started, I just want to make sure you know that my Google Cardboard game is actually out on Google Play Store, which is called Whisper Dungeon. If you're interested in to try something scary, well, feel free to click the link down below and hopefully you enjoy the game. Without further ado, let's start the tutorial. First, we need to download all the assets from Admob.
Go to the Google Lens mobile plugin and just download the zip file. That's the first thing we need. So here, /Google Lens /Google Lens -mobile-plugins/release. So here, we just download the Unity plugin. Let's go to Unity. Now we just import the package, assets, import package, custom package. So that's the Google Mobile Ads Unity package, and just open this. Here we'll import all the files, and that's not it yet. We actually need to put in the Google Play Services library into the plugins under Android folder, because right now here only has the Google Mobile Ads plugin. And let's go to the folder, find where we put the SDK, the Android SDK. If you have not downloaded it, please do so. And go to the SDK folder and go to the extras and go to Google Play Services and copy this folder, Google-play-services_lib folder. And right-click the Android folder in the project setting in Unity and reveal in Finder. Just paste this library here because we need this one to be there. If you do not have the Google Play packages, here's how you're updating it. Go to the SDK folder again, find the tools folder, and here is an Android application. You can just click open it. This just open all the list of platforms and everything that's installed or not installed. The Google Play services is usually at the bottom. It's here, just check this and then install all the packages and just wait. It can take a little while based on how many things you need to install. Since I have this already, and we can just close that up. Let's go back to Unity. So there are a couple more things. I notice it's really buggy in this Google Mobile Ads plugin. Just click on the manifest. It's always looking for Google Play Services version. However, that file is actually not being included. And also this theme file, the in-app purchase activity theme, is always like nowhere to be found. So we should just delete this. It just define the theme. If you really want to work on the in-app purchases theme, you can do that later. But for our purposes, let's just delete the theme first. Save it. And go back to Unity. We will just copy one of the XML from the other project. So do you remember we already had the Google Play Services lib? So just go to the resource folder, go to the values and the version, just review in Finder. We will just copy this file and just create exactly the same tree in the Google Mobile Ads plugin. So we can create the same tree, right? So here just need a resource folder, just create a folder and name it res. They put everything in values folders. Here we just create a values folder, and in values folder we just paste the file we just copied. So this way, when we are making a build, the Unity is not going to throw us errors, say like cannot find the version number. It took me a little while to figure it out, so definitely have to do that in order to make sure your things are working. Here is a project. We need to run a test. So there's a testing script already built for us. It's in some of the testing files. So let's just open the sample we have. Do you remember, at first we downloaded the sample. Just unzip this file. We just need to copy the demo we got from the sample. So sample assets. So this is the one, so demo script. Let's just copy this script and create a script folder in the assets folder. Just paste this demo script into our project. Takes it a while, we'll refresh. Just attach this to the camera. We can take a quick look at the script. So here we need to updating the add unit ID. I have pasted mine. So this is the banner ID, and here is the interstitial ID. Those are have to be updated. Okay, and also I have a key here. How do you find all your Admob setting? Of course, go to your Admob. You need to register and everything. Actually, I'm using the same setup. You can see my Admob test. Those are the IDs. I created two. Here, the full screen is actually called interstitial. And the banner, those are the IDs you need to copy and then paste it into your C# script. This way it's gonna show the ads you want. We're back in Unity again. One last thing, we need to make a build. So file, build settings, and add current scene. Just save it, create a new folder. Say demo Unity. Before we click build, we need to switch to Android if we not have done so. Click player setting. Here we definitely need to change the bundle identifier again. Com.company name. The app name. So that's it. I don't see anything else. We do not need to sign this. It's totally fine for this testing purposes. And just click build and run.
I am on my Android phone. Let's just click the menu, find the application. Mine is called Hello World, and let's just call it request banner. Now banner is showing, and destroy banner, and request interstitial, and then show it. Now it's showing. It's great. Let's closing it. Well, everything is working. Hopefully yours is working as well. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this video is straightforward enough for you. The iOS version will be posted after 2 weeks. Stay tuned. See you next time. Bye for now.
I'm going to start a series about iOS Unity.